morning. Welcome back to Erasmus TV. Today is an important milestone in the slow reopening of campus. Some shops will reopen and more study spaces will be made available. However, reopening campus doesn't come without hurdles and difficulties to overcome. We will talk about that today with our guests, Sandra Klarenbeek and Rutger Engels. Very welcome. But first of all, Rutger, yesterday was also an important day. It was the last day that new students could enroll themselves. And this date, the 1st of June, has been mentioned quite a lot at this table. Mm-hmm. It was said that it would give an important indication for the amount of new students that would coming, and so the financial future of the university. So I'm wondering, are the prospects as sunny as today's weather, or is it quite the opposite?
So far it looks promising, because the admission data, they look good. So we have about 10% more students administered than last year at the same time. But of course, we don't know how many of the people that actually administered will actually register. And that is a really important issue. So I think half of August, we know more about that. And then we actually know what the financial repercussions are.
So we have a new date, half of August.
Yes, that's really important for us and, of course, for all the schools.
And will we wait till then? Now, and today is also an important day, Sandra, because 50 study spaces got available at the university library.
Yes.
First, it was announced that it would be 318. That's quite a difference. Why this drop?
Yes, why this drop? What the library did first was look what's physically possible in the building when you take into account the measure of the RVM of 1.5 meters. And what they saw is that 380 spots would be possible. So that was the first number. We were very happy. But you also have to take into account that there's also a measure that no more than 30 people can be in one room. And what exactly is one room? So as long as we don't know for sure, we'd rather be careful and be safe for everyone. So that drops down the number a bit. And the other thing that I think is important, that we don't know what happens when the library opens. People have to make a reservation, but yeah, how many people will come? How is the traffic at the door? How is the traffic in the building? So we think it's safe to start with 50 study spaces first, and then if everything goes well, then I hope we can, as soon as possible, scale up with like 50 persons a week.
But you had already some experience, because in the Tinbergen building, some spaces were already available for students who were most in need. But I heard that not everybody shows up to those 50 study spaces. Can you elaborate on that?
Yes. Well, what we see is that of all the reservation made, approximately 50% has a no-show. So 50% of the spots are empty, which is a shame, because those spots are for the students most in need. And we have to disappoint a lot of people, because everything is reserved already. So I think what students do is they think, well, I make a reservation just in case, and then they look if they want to come or not. So I really hope students realize that these spots are scarce and they really have to think about coming yes or no, and realize that this is not very social behavior.
Yeah. I see you nodding, Rutger. What do you think of this 50% no show up?
I think these are startup problems. I mean, once students realize, it's exactly what Sandra is saying, is that that it affects other people who won't actually come, they will change their behavior. So I think in a short while this is solved.
Yes. Last Thursday we went to the Tinbergen building to talk with, well, one of the students who actually showed up.
Mijn naam is Floor en ik studeer criminologie, tweede jaar. Ik zit hier omdat ik thuis heel weinig discipline heb. Dus ik doe daar dan te weinig. Dus toen ik zag dat hier studieplekken vrij kwamen, toen dacht ik, nou, is weer een mooie tijd om al mijn achterstand een beetje in te gaan halen. Om hier een studieplek te krijgen, moet je dus reserveren. Er zijn dan twee timeslots. En eentje is dan van 9 tot 1 en anders van 2:30 tot 5:30. En dan kan je dus inschrijven voor wanneer je wilt. In een lokaal zijn de computers zijn afgetaped, waardoor er tussen zeg maar twee mensen zit dan een lege computer. En ook zijn gewoon een aantal rijen helemaal niet beschikbaar gesteld. Dus ja, de capaciteit is misschien een derde. Als ik reserveer, dan zie ik wel dat de plekken vrij snel soort van vol zijn. Maar ik zit ook wel regelmatig hier, dat dan de helft van het lokaal eigenlijk leeg is.
When I see this video, it also makes me wonder if students are missing out, if they really, really need a spot. Do you have any indication of this?
How many are missing out?
Now, if somebody really needs this spot, but now they're perhaps missing out because it's booked, do you get any messages of this? Students say, but I still really need it?
No. We can't see that.
Wouldn't it just be easier, because you said we're talking about 30 people in a room, just to open up more buildings here on campus? Because we have quite a lot of buildings. So just why not open just another one?
Yes. Well, we're working on that right now, because that's what we want too. But opening up a building is not as simple as just opening the front door. You have to do a lot inside the building, and you also have to look at measures outside the building, because what do you do when 6,000 students come to Plug building hoping to find a study spot? And you have to also, like coffee machines, the copiers, the everything, cleaning, you have to rotate the traffic inside the building, at the entrance, of course, but also elevators, stairways. So there's a lot to do. And at the same time, we also have to look at the offices, because staff wants to come back at campus as well. We have to look at the lecture rooms for coming September. So it's a lot to do, and I think it's best that we do that safe, because otherwise there might be a risk, and that's not what we want to have on campus.
Can you already imagine how campus life would look like, well, starting of September?
Yeah, I think we'll accommodate as many students as possible. We really want to welcome especially new students at our campus. But at the same time, if the measure still is 1.5 meter, then, well, maybe approximately 20% of the normal campus population can be on campus. So it's also good to know that it's not campus is opening and then it's the old campus again. It's we're far from that.
Rutger, we hear a lot of messages that students don't feel that this online education is a fully fledged alternative. We saw and even this weekend another petition to, well, get a refund or do something else. Do you think a reduction of the tuition fee would be justified?
So I think, so what we actually do is as much as possible. So I think our lecturers, our staff is working hard as they can to provide this blended learning from September onwards, and now it's fully online. That's the consequence of the crisis we are in, and we need to face that. So what we're working right now with all the people is to be ready for September 1st. And what we really want is a hybrid form of education, not just online, because I fully agree. Learning is more than sitting behind your laptop.
Then do you also agree that perhaps if you have to pay an intuition fee when you're from outside the European Union, you have to pay at least 10,000 a year, that it's too much for a hybrid form?
Well, I'm not going to into this kind of discussions, but I think we will provide a really good alternative for the situation right now, given the circumstances we are in and who is the whole society is in. So we really need to face that.
Yes. With a full intuition fee for now.
Yes.
Well, then thank you here for coming. Thank you for sharing the stories, and thank you all for watching. We will be back here on Thursday. And remember, if you're in Rotterdam tomorrow and you're going to Schouwburgplein, where there is a Support for America protest, or at least a gathering, Erasmus Magazine will make a video there. Come say hello, but don't forget to wear your mouth mask and, of course, keep your distance. Thank you.